Hey everyone, welcome to Our Church. We hope that you're staying safe and that you had a blessed week. In the next few moments, we're going to start off with some songs, and I pray that you would be filled with God's love and His joy as we worship Him. I encourage you, if you can, to stand up and let's sing together. Give thanks.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise and sing praise. With a mighty hand and outstretched arm, His love endures forever. And for the life that's been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, and sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is and forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, and forever. And forever God is faithful, and forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, forever, forever.
From the rising.
From the rising to the setting sun, His love endures forever. And by the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. And sing praise. And sing praise. And sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful, and forever God is strong. And forever God is with us, and forever and ever. And forever God is faithful, and forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, and forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever and ever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever. Forever God is faithful, and forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, and forever and ever. And forever God is faithful, and forever God is strong. And forever God is with us, and forever. Forever.
Amen.
Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. Your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. And right now, I know you're able. And my God, come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. Everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now. Breaking my heart of stone, taking over like it's Jericho. And my walls are all crashing down. But right now, I know you're able. And my God, come through again. And you can do all things. And you can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. And you can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. You never lost a battle, Lord. No, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. No, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. No, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. No, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. Oh. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. But you never lost a battle. Cause you never lost a battle. I know, you never will. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. I know, you never will.
You are here.
And you are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, you're moving in our midst. worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here and touching every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are here. You're healing every You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. And you are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 Oh, that's you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. You're way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. And nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. Thank you. wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is, and nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus.
You didn't want.
You didn't want heaven without us. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. And what could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is, and nothing can stand against. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. Oh. What a wonderful death could not hold you, the veil tore before you, and silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival. You have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. Oh, what a powerful name it is, oh, what a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, and nothing can stand against. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. And you have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. And what a beautiful name it is, and what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. And what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names, the name of Jesus. You are way maker, miracle. darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Let's keep on trusting in the Lord and remember who He is. He loves us and will always come through. This week, Pastor Fiona has a word to encourage us as we follow and grow in the Lord. But before that, let's pray. Father God, I thank you for every person here. May you speak to each one of them and give them breakthrough and hope in the word we're about to hear. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's listen in.
Good morning, church, or good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching it from, I send you greetings. Today, we're going to continue on from the series that we started off last week as the beginning of the year. I sure hope that you're still settling in and figuring things out. Maybe some things have changed in the new year. Some of us who have gone back to work and this is the first week back, I hope you've had a great one or you needed to recoup this weekend. But I want to bring greetings and also encouragement to you this morning. So we're going to go right into the scriptures and I pray that you follow along. If you have your Bibles, please do bring it out. Let's go into the word. And so last week we talked about what tree you're in, and I hope you got a chance to ponder and pray and kind of, you know, go through the process here. You know, I just want you to know that, you know, I picked up journaling again, and it actually really is helpful to write down the things of the Lord with a pen because we're so used to doing the devices, which is great too. But I realized that for me, when I begin to pick up the pen and begin to pen it down on a piece of paper, I think it slowed down the process for me a whole lot more, where I take time to listen a whole lot more. And versus where on the device, there's a clock on it. And for some reason, I'm hurrying through my time and I'm not listening as long as I should be. So I just want to right off the bat say it now is, if that is you like me, I want to encourage you, pick up a pen, you know, take those times, put the phone away where you really get to listen to the Lord and write down the things that He's speaking to you. And so this morning I want to bring us into the scripture. It's in 1 Corinthians 13:11. It says, "When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I grew up. I gave up my childish ways." 1 Corinthians 14:20 says, "Do not be children in your thinking, be infants in evil, but in your thinking, be matured." Now, I want to talk about this morning, following along from what we started last week about what tree and seasons and being anchored in Christ as well. And this week, as I was praying for us and just really asking the Lord, what is the word, the rhema word for us for this week? And I just felt like the Lord was saying that in this season of waiting and pondering, it all has to do with the way we think as well, and the way how we anchor ourselves. Are we anchoring in Christ? But then there's some things where we're like, well, I want to be in control. Or do we throw them all in there where we put all the hope in Him? And that actually has to do a lot with our thinking. And sometimes, you know, thinking, we could, you know, kind of doubt God and be in a very different place and mindset as well. But in the scripture, with what I challenged you last week about what the seasons that we're in and what tree we are, I just felt like God was saying is, you know, are we maturing in Him? And are there things that we need to put away where maybe we thought like that when we were 5 or 15 or even 25, but now that we are older, that we need to think differently with the mind of Christ. And as disciples, we ought to be maturing in Him always and continually maturing in Him. And there are times where we struggle to be able to move forward and to have the mind of Christ, because now that we are probably 85 and yet we still think like a 15-year-old, it just doesn't work that way. And so I just felt like the Lord was encouraging us, will you give Him the baggages that is actually holding you back, or you're struggling to be able to move forward and to exercise and to grow because you're hanging on to what a 15-year-old would hang on to, because it was safe, because it's secure, because it's for sure, like there was a promise there, or that you hang on to. And it was kind of like a safety blanket where we hang on to, like, well, but God, you did it here this way. And then 20 years later, you're still hoping that God's going to do it that way. And that we would have totally missed out what the Lord has for us, because he's not going to do the same thing the same way every time. And yet his promises are yes and amen. And so in this season, they're growing and learning, and in the season of unknown as well, even with the new year, you know, I encourage you that the Lord is asking us to anchor ourselves in him. And while we anchor ourselves in him, we've got to grow up. We got to mature. And so before we go anywhere further, I just want to encourage you, if you have a piece of paper, you know, take it out and write down some of those what you need to leave behind and what you need to grow up with. And so, you know, for example, if there are things that you know, and you know, like, you know what, I can't think of like that this way anymore, and I've got to grow up. And so you want to put away the childish ways, and then you want to move forward, and God's going to help you in that, in those moments. He's going to give you the strength to be able to grow and mature in him. Now, I want to give you another scripture. It's Ephesians chapter 4, 14 to 15. It says, so that we may no longer be children, tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by the wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness in deceitful schemes. Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ. And so I do want to encourage us and to remind us and to challenge us that are there things of our lives, and it's particularly sometimes when we are in a very tough situation, do we go back to that moment where we are tossing and turning, and we are acting, you know, nobody wants to really own out about, you know, I'm not being matured and I'm acting like a kid. I think most of us are not quick in jumping that, but perhaps there are people around us that have we given permission to speak into our lives, and they're able to point it out, and hopefully with a lot of grace and with a lot of love to be like, hey, I think you need to, you know, or what's happening, or, you know, some of us, we might have good mamas that says, no, hey, you need to grow up. And so I want to encourage us that we would look at the scripture with encouragement from the Lord, that we would no longer be children, and we would pick it up, and that we would be encouraged, and we would grow in Christ, because he says we are to grow up in every way into him who is the head of Christ. And so I'm not asking you to just, you know, pull up your big girl pants and grow up. That's not what I'm saying. But I believe that the Lord is saying in the scripture that we will speak the truth in love, and we are to grow up in every way, that he is the head. Christ is the head of our lives. Our anchor is in him, and that we are to take inventories. And January is a really great month to take inventories of our lives, because there are going to be things that we're not going to wait till spring cleaning. There are things in our spiritual walk with him that, you know, to start a fresh year, no matter what's happening around us. Yes, there's still a pandemic. Yes, there's still a lockdown. Yes, there's so much still unknown. However, Jesus is always the known. He's always famous. He's famous for his promises. And God has never failed us. And he will never leave you nor forsake you, says the Lord. And so while we are maturing and we're taking inventories, what are some of the things that we need to get rid of where we give it to Christ? Where we say, hey, God, you know what? Here it is. Here it is. And yes, I am scared out of my mind because it's been my safety blanket. But I'm going to trade that safety blanket with you, Christ, because you are my safety blanket, because you are my safe place, because I can hide in the shadow of your wings, and that I will renew my strength. It says right in the scripture. And so I want to encourage you, church, that you will not be tossed and turned by things of the world, but that you will hang on to these scriptures, that your anchor would be in him. Like, drop that anchor and be like, you know what, it has to be with Christ, because everything else in this world has just been cray cray. People have lost control in their emotions and feelings in a lot of ways because we're scared, because there's so much unknown. But church, I want to encourage you that has disciples, that we will hang on to him. And that brings me to the next scriptures to you. Remember how last week I was talking about, like, how, you know, what kind of roots you are growing as a tree, and what kind of tree are you? And so today I want us to also read the scriptures in John 15, 1 to 4. It says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. And it says, you are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you, which is Jesus. And then first verse says, remain in me and I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. And that is another reminder to us that in this season and has a tree in him is, are we hooked up with him? Are we bearing fruits? Not by our own strength, but are we allowing our Father who is the gardener? Isn't that crazy? Sometimes when I read this, it just baffles me because I am so glad he's not saying that I am, that he is the true vine and I also need to learn how to be a gardener, which is great too for those of you who like the garden. But I'm so grateful every day that my Father is the gardener and that I can mess up the garden and he will still be the gardener. And so I want to encourage us that we don't have to fret that we got to be perfect, because that's not what he's asking of us. He's asking us that we are to remain in him and that he would cut off every branch that would bear no fruit, and he's going to be the one to prune. So it sounds like he just wants me to be contented in him, and that as long as I'm connecting him, he's going to do the pruning, he's going to do the cutting, and that we're going to see more fruits than we have ever known, not on our own strength. And he also reminds us that we are already clean because of what he's spoken and asked. And so church, will you, like I said, anchor in him? I can't stress that even more for this week, is that you will remain in him and he also remain in you, and that you will bear good fruit. The scriptures actually goes on to say in John 15 in verse 26 to 27, but when the helper comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who processes from the Father, and he will bear witness about me. And you also will bear witnesses, because you have been with me from the beginning. And so who is this helper that God's talking about in the scripture? He's talking about Jesus. He's talking about how, you know, God will send us, Jesus, the Spirit of truth, in which he already did. Which he already did. And so at this moment, I want to say, those of you watching and you're kind of on the fence, I don't really know, but you're watching and you feel that tug in your heart, I want to encourage you, even right now, you've never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I want to encourage you today. He is your helper and he is your Savior, and that it will be the best commitment you've ever made in your life, and that he will be there for you as he's already been. But to acknowledge that he's the Spirit of truth in your life, to acknowledge that he's the Savior of the world, I want to encourage you today that if that is you, that you would say that prayer. And it doesn't have to be, you know, the right words to say, but that you would be able to acknowledge, is the acknowledge of the heart, is like, you know, Jesus, you are the king of my heart. I admit that I am a sinner and that you came and died on the cross for me, and I receive you now as my Lord and Savior. And I confessed that you are King and Lord in Jesus' name. And that's what it is. And so church, if you're the one who said that prayer today, and whoever invited you to be part of this channel, I'm going to ask you to just message them, let them know what you did, and then we'll be able to walk you through this process, because we're never meant to walk this faith journey alone. So just going back to that scripture, for the rest of us, says, you know, in verse 27, it says, you also will bear witnesses because you have been with me from the beginning. There's another translation that actually says that when you do that, you represent as a disciple. And, you know, a lot of times we throw that word around, right? It's like, you know, I'm a Christian, so therefore I'm a disciple. You know, I am this and therefore I am an ambassador to Christ. And those are all not incorrect. Those are all correct. But part of being a disciple is to speak the truth. Is to bear witness. And sometimes there are seasons where we bear witness in our lifestyle than the words that we say. You know, it's kind of tricky sometimes, because in a lot of ways we are also growing and learning and maturing, and sometimes some of us aren't quite ready for that, and that's okay. And so I want to encourage you, wherever and whatever season you're in, whatever tree you're in, that you are matured in him, that while you're maturing in him, that you will bear witness of the Lord Jesus Christ, that you will represent the Father and the Father well, not out of perfection, but out of your heart, that you be able to bear what you already know, bear what you're living out, bear the testimonies that has already passed. Those are those hope things that we can speak of and to share at the table with our friends, with our family, because it has already happened, because you know, and you know, because you've lived it out. And so another scriptures that I want to share with you is 2 Peter 3:18. but grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. To him be the glory, both now and to the day of eternity. 2 Peter 3:18. He says to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. You know, sometimes when we talk about grace, you're not talking about a free pass to do what you need to do. It's not a free pass where it's like, if I say the prayer, I go to heaven. Even though when we speak the truth and we say, Lord Jesus, you are my Lord and Savior, and that eternity is promised for us. Yes, 100%. But I think the scriptures, when he says, talk about to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes for those of us who are really hard on ourselves, and you know, last week we talked about being go-getters, some of us are extreme above ants, right? Some of us are really go-getters and we're barely getting rest. And then the other one of us are just like going with the flow. But I talked about expectations in the Lord, because when we're going really fast and faster than the Lord will allow us to, and then those of us who are just kind of chilling, kicking it back, and we're not really expecting then. You're not really expecting how the Lord is going to show up and what he's required of us. What do you suddenly ask you to slow down? Or he asks you to stop chilling and I want you to fast forward. And so when we talk about growing in the grace of the Lord, we are living with grace every single day, the moment we wake up to the moment that we go to bed. He's already set the day before us. And so church, in this season, how would you grow in the grace for yourself in the Lord Jesus Christ and with the people around you? Some of us need to learn how to be kind to ourselves and to grow in that grace. Some of us need to show and extend that grace to the people around us. You know, sometimes we're really hard on the people that we love the most, isn't it? And so I want to encourage you, whether they're believers or not, I want to encourage you, you'd be surprised how God is going to show up in these places when we just begin to abide in him and to let his grace wash over us, and that we begin to extend grace to ourselves and then to others. You know, the scriptures at the beginning that I started off with about the abiding, he also talked about that if you follow these commandments, that you would not only love the Lord, but that you would love others as well. And so I want to end with that scripture today to encourage you, is that to love the Lord all your heart, mind, soul, okay, and then to love your neighbor as yourself. And so I want to encourage you that you will love God and also love your neighbor. And neighbors would be like anyone, your family, your friends, your coworkers, that those are all your neighbors. And then to be in that grace, because we're not going to be able to do that if we're not taking inventories of ourselves, where we're able to say, okay, be very honest between you and God. Right? Because sometimes when we do inventories ourselves, we're like, yeah, I'm amazing. Yeah, I'm wonderful. Yeah, I'm this. Or some of us are like, no, I suck at this, and I'm not this, and I'm not that. And you become this hopeless person. Again, extreme to the both ends. But I want you to take honest inventory with the Lord Jesus Christ. What is it about us that God is encouraging us that we need to grow up, that we need to mature in? Because that gives us these, you know, some of my boys would tell me, like, you know, I need some six packs. I need to grow my muscles. And so I'm talking about, spiritually speaking, it's the spiritual muscles inside of us. And that starts with having inventory ourselves, maturing. And the last scripture that ended with you is about having grace. And so I bless you, church. May you be filled with wisdom and discernment. May you be filled with his grace for yourself and for your household and those that you have a privilege to be friends with and to influence with as well. May the favor of the Lord be upon you. May he bless you abundantly. I love you. I miss you so much to be gathering in person. But while we are persevering and while we're keeping ourselves safe, I pray that while you're at home or however creative way that you are learning from school or at work, whichever way that you have made it work, I want to say to you, you're doing better than you think, and that God is so proud of you. And so may you have grace upon yourself and those around you. I bless you, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Wow. Thanks, Pastor Fiona. I know that for me personally, I really needed that reminder that God's grace is there for me as I go through the growth process. I pray that you would remember the same as you listen and walk out what the Lord has for you. Well, that wraps up this week. Let us know if there's any way that we can pray for you. And remember that you are loved, you belong, and stay hopeful. See ya.